Good afternoon, I am S.P. Venugopal, Chief Engineer. I have been working in Abbott for last 8 years. I am taking classes for this BE Marine, BS Nautical Science, and as well as I am course in charge for ETO, Electrotechnical Officers. And here this BE second year students, I am taking the subject of Boiler and Steam Engineering. So there you have from the fundamentals to see the thermal engineering subjects. Just to switch over to the boiler types, where you have different type of boilers used on board ship. There are types like main boiler, tank boiler, auxiliary boiler. So nowadays this, boilers are, some of the boilers are so modern, it is completely fully automated, and so some of the old boilers, the versions are now scrapped now. The new boilers like 5-tube boiler, water tube boiler are developed nowadays. So if you go back to history, it is a main boiler used for main propulsion. Nowadays you don't use any steam for steam propulsion, all become motor vessels. So they don't call it main boiler, now it's called only auxiliary boiler. So the boiler also, the tank type boiler, vertical boiler or horizontal tubes or vertical tubes, they call it a boiler with large water carrying capacity, where the shell is used as a tank, whereas where the tubes or gases passes through. Below that you have a chamber where the fuel is burnt and heat is developed. So there are the tank boiler, you have a vertical type of boiler and horizontal type of boiler. The only difference is the shell is upright when it is horizontal, the second last one. Then you have a auxiliary boiler. Now some ships, when they have the main boiler, they have auxiliary boiler only for heating purpose. Their capacity is very low, as good as 5 to 6 kg, 6 bar pressure. You can't use it for any main purpose or any turbines or running any machinery. They are only meant for using only heating purposes. So doggy boiler, they call it a doggy boiler. They are only supplying hot water. Then some vessels like your all this catering, this so they use the doggy boiler only supplying hot water. Exhaust gas boiler. This is the most important thing, because besides your auxiliary boiler, most of the ships are having exhaust boiler. The exhaust boiler is what you are using the waste heat recovery by using the main exhaust gases to heat up the water in the exhaust boiler. That's the reason this exhaust boiler is called economizer. The different name of the exhaust boiler is called as economizer. So where you operate by the hot gases from the main is passed through, instead of going to the atmosphere, it passes through the exhaust gas boiler. So how they connect it? Now exhaust boiler is another part, auxiliary boiler will be different there. So in port you use auxiliary boiler by burning fuel and produce steam. Moment the vessel sail out, exhaust boiler comes into action because of the exhaust gases. The steam produced the exhaust boiler come back to the auxiliary boiler. So this both auxiliary boiler and exhaust boiler are interconnected. That is the system as of now in the lot of most of the vessels. So how this, when the steam is coming back again, how this interconnection, what they do during sailing, just before sailing, we start a circulating hot water circulating pump that is suction from the auxiliary boiler, put into the exhaust boiler, and the steam produces coming back to the auxiliary boiler. This is a cycle. Any shortage of water in the auxiliary boiler will be filled by the feed pumps separated into the auxiliary boiler, not to the exhaust boiler. It will be directly given to the auxiliary boiler. Okay. Now, generally, in general cargo ships, you have an auxiliary boiler or exhaust boiler. Whatever the tank is, where you are using lot of steam requirement is there for cargo turbine pumps. There is a water tube boiler, they call drum type boiler. That means they have a water drum and steam drum, a huge boiler. It is pressure is going above almost more than 20 bar pressure. So that is a drum type of water tube boilers employing steam and water turbines. When the turbines are involved, you have to have a water tube type boiler. There is a different boiler used in the most of the ships actually, most of the tankers. The other one is package boiler. Package boiler is a boiler, you can have, keep it anywhere in the ship. In case if you have a problem in the ship, with the main boiler now, you can get this baggage boiler like a container. It will be self-contained everything. You have a drum, you have a low capacity boiler pack inside a box set casing, capable of quick steam production, flexible position. So what they do, they have a flexible line connection from this baggage boiler. You can keep it on the deck or the up deck of the vessel. From there you can take the, but remember that with this baggage boiler you cannot run turbine or anything. You can use it for sailing or heating purposes. For example, heating the fuel oil or lube oil for sailing purpose, you can carry on to the voyage. But when you come to the port only, you are going to do the cargo discharging, That time you can't use this package boiler. You have to repair that main boiler and get that turbines working. Okay, let us go to the next one. Motor vessels. Now the motor vessels, normally what do they have? Two steam generating system. One is exhaust gas economizer, auxiliary boiler. As I told you before, these two are the part of the vessel now. So during port, you use the auxiliary boiler. And in sea, you use exhaust boiler, so that auxiliary boiler is mostly ideal. Only the steam pressure will be there. No combustion or firing of oil, nothing take place there. These boiler system function under the very principle of heat transfer, and both the boilers are interlinked. So the auxiliary boiler is not used for retaining the produced steam. Whatever the auxiliary boiler is pumped to the exhaust boiler, you see the boiler separating pump and the main engine is in service. That's the system, separating system. Now they, let us come to the switch of the Scotch type of boiler. This is a vertical boiler where you have a furnace in the bottom. A number of tubes are there. When the furnace is going, when the furnace fuel is burned, the gases uptake, it goes through that gases and comes to the smoke tube design and go to the uptake. So water around this area, the complete shell is having a steam tubes, and steam tube, they have a steam tube, they didn't say, they are only for purpose of strengthening the thing, because a lot of thermal expansion take place, this is seen. So because so much heat is being produced here, this goes over to the furnace and comes to the tubes, and so water surrounded by this. The entire area is separated by the water, filled up with the water. So this is the basic concept of Scotch boiler. Now fire and smoke tube boiler, same purpose only. What is the same thing? Fire tube, they call fire tube or smoke tube. That means the smoke is going through the tubes. That is called, it's called fire tubes. Water is surrounded by that. What is given in Scotch boiler before? The same principle only, it is the Scotch boiler is little more clear picture is going here. Here you have a water level. Water level is maintained above the tube level. Any time the water level can drop below that, then these tubes are going to collapse. So you have to maintain the water level is very important. The manuals are given for inspection. When you shut out the boiler, you can go for inspection. And here is the burner is fitted. The burner is fitted means burner is having a fuel injector. They have a damper fan for supplying air. The sufficient amount of air is required, I mean, for the combustion. So the exhaust goes out to the atmosphere. So then this place is called combustion chamber, where it is called furnace. So this is the thing, the main component of Scotch boiler consists of induction containing the furnace, combustion chamber and end grating. The furnace construction is on the form of corrugated cylinder in which fuel is burned in the furnace. After leaving the furnace, hot water, hot gases enter the combustion chamber and passes through the smoke tubes, which consists of plain and steam tubes. The plain tubes, actually in fact the heat transfer takes place. Steam tubes are only for strengthening purpose. After leaving the tubes, the gas enters the smoke box and boiler uptake. Boiler uptake is the portion, this is the portion, they call it boiler uptake. Most of the boilers, they have a carbon deposit. The unburned fuel can go through the tubes and go to this area, settle down here, and there are the chances of uptake fire. So you have to have a proper system of perfect combustion so that no unburned fuel or anything left out in the uptake. In case of any uptake fire, you have to handle the thing with the firefighting systems are deployed to exist in the fire. So this uptake fire is the one thing, you have to be very careful. Once you leave the atmosphere, nothing to fear about that. Till that time, you have to have a perfect combustion to prevent any uptake fire. Now we come to the composite boiler. What is composite boiler? The main component of the Scotch boiler composite boiler are mixed with diesel engines, exhaust gas, and flue gases for the fuel burner. Now, instead of having two separate boilers, economizer or auxiliary boiler, why don't you have a composite boiler? Composite boiler means one boiler, simultaneously you can use both. I mean, there are tubes. So composite boiler mixes the diesel engine, exhaust gas, and flue gas from the auxiliary boiler burner. Both can pass through, same furnace, from the furnace also, as well as from the main engine. Starting, stopping, and moderating the burner normally carried by the steam pressure actuated controls. The old days, a huge damper was used to bypass exhaust gases, the steam demand was less. Nowadays, the control was used to dump excess steam to the steam condenser. Okay, I'll show you that composite boiler. Now, like the system is like that. We have a furnace here, normally used to burn the oil, and this comes over here. And from the diesel engine, main engine, this oil, gas also comes over here, passes through the two tubes, comes out like this, is a double pass. This is one pass, another second pass. Then it goes through the burner. Now this area, from here to up to the bottom, the blue, so you can see the blue color level full of water. And this is the steam space. That dome space is a dome space is given curvature to withstand the pressure. Withstand the pressure, bigger withstand the pressure. Now here, in case you are if you are using the main engine, sailing tank, same model we use. You slow down the engine, the pressure drops. Same time the gas. What do you need? Higher pressure, 6 bar, 7 bar pressure to be maintained in the steam line to for heating. See, the heating is conducive for main engine, fuel air system, purifiers, and many places. So when the steam demand is there, in case you happen to reduce the engine RPM, the flow of the gases from the engine will reduce. That time this burner can start automatically. Most of the ships, they start automatically, inject the fuel and burn the burner. So the same burner you can use exhaust gas as well as this one. When the steam demand is there, for example, the engine is running at a higher speed, you are running at 115 RPM. Already auxiliary boiler is off, but the steam pressure is going up beyond 8 bar pressure. Then that what they do, the excess steam is produced when it dumped to the condenser. There is something called the outlet. When the steam is there, you can open the steam, the separate condenser is there, and then you can dump the condenser so that excess pressure will be dropped. Or some of the ships, what they do before coming here, they have a bypass line. This is a bypass means that this will be a damper here. You don't allow the gas to go through this exhaust boiler, straight away go to the atmosphere. That means bypassing. That's what is written there. Huge damper was used to bypass the exhaust gases. Or when the steam demand was less. When your steam demand is less, you have closed down all the heating. Now you have stopped all the heating. You close the valve, the steam demand became less, then the pressure will shoot up. That way you can bypass the gases. Otherwise, you can dump the exhaust steam to the steam condenser. So this is called composite boiler. This water tube boiler, for use in the most of tankers, they have a drum, steam and water drum here, connected with the number of tubes. So the basic principle is like that. There's a steam drum, the water tubes are there, furnace is here. Because why this water tube is water tube boiler is more efficient compared to fire tube? Because the surface area where it finds the exposed is much more, so you can dump a higher pressure. They call water tube boiler. The water tube boilers are more used in tankers. So this is the explanation of water tube boiler. Steam is passed through the auxiliary system, then enters the condenser, where it condenses to the pump water, where pumped back to the feed line, completely the boiler feed water system. Now whatever the water coming out of the steam which is coming out of the boiler, it is being used in the systems. You have a regulating valve. It goes through the, say for example you have turbines, then from the turbine outlet it goes to the condenser and become water again. Suppose if you have no water, the steam is coming out, there will be a condenser, there will be a get cooled and become water, it will go to a hot well. There will be a conducting tank. They call feed water tank. Feed water tank, you can see the water level. So whatever the excess steam or the water which is condensed will come back to the feed water tank. From there you can take the water back to the boiler using a feed water pump. The feed water pumps also duplicated. One pump is there, always in use, in case you, that is always in automatic. Depending on the water level, that feed water pump starts and fill up the water to maintain the level to the boiler. Second thing is, if you have any emergency, the water level drops, then you can always start the second pump and start the thing to maintain the level in the boiler. Maintaining the water level in the boiler is most important, because remember that any time water level falls down, the things might collapse very fast. That's why you have provided safety valves. You can release the pressure to prevent any abnormal increase of pressure in the boilers. So there are proper mountings, boiler steam mountings. These are mountings: main steam stop valve, auxiliary steam stop valve, flow down valve, air vent valve, salinometer valve. These things are scum valve, pressure gauge valve. I will just briefly tell you what is the importance of that. First valve is main steam stop valve is to give the steam to every well supply line. Then auxiliary steam stop valve is the valve which is used for the heating purposes. Suppose you have a main line which is going to the thing, and say auxiliary steam also. So, then feed check valve is the valve which is through which water is going inside the boiler. Water level indicator, they call galley glass, From there, you can see the level. Nowadays, most of the boilers are automatic. You have remote water level indicators. The remote water level indicators can control them itself. Low water level alarms are there. The most important thing, low water level alarms. In case it comes, the boiler shut down automatically. Then, blow down valve. You have a excess chlorine content in the boiler. You can blow down the valve to the ship. Air vent valve. Release any excess air. Then, salinometer valve. Then, where you can take the sample. You can take a sample and test the water so that it can, the chlorine level, alkalinity level of the water can be maintained by maintaining the water, what you call, salinity of the water. Same time, you have to have a controlled alkalinity level of the water in that thing. The most important thing is the level, water quality has to be maintained in the boiler. Scum wall, any oil or any sludge floating in the boiler can be blown out using the scum wall. And pressure gauge cock indicates the pressure. Okay, that's what today for this class. Thank you very much for listening to me. If you have any queries, you can contact me later. Thank you very much.